Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me this evening. At 3:32 p.m. local time, there by Meltone, Texas, there was a magnitude 5.4 earthquake. Altogether today, there was 6 earthquakes, starting out with this 5.4. They're all pretty shallow, and it's not by fracking. These were caused by wastewater disposal being pumped into the ground. About 70% of the earthquakes there in Texas are caused by the production of oil and gas. Long as they keep turning a profit, they do not care that they are the bad guys. Just like the inflation, the fake shortage of fuel, they don't care if you label them the devil themselves. Long as they get their profits. 1,040 people reported to USGS that they felt this earthquake. I really think they're working with the government to cause the shortage. Like I said, they don't care if they're the bad guy as long as they keep getting their profits. Look at this. It was felt over, pretty much the entire state of Texas, all the way down to the coast, Corpus Christi, all the way south to Amarillo, Texas, Albuquerque, New Mexico, it looks like. Yeah. Some of the felt reports that were sent in to EMSC, noticeable shaking lasted about 45 seconds to a minute. And let's see, what's another one? That was strange, it says. First experience with one, scary. Artesia, it comes from. 140 miles northwest. Shaking of foundation to the house. Couch in the living room was shaking. I felt it in my building shaking. Let's see, Odessa. I knew it. The floor of the house was shaking long enough for my son to come find me and ask me what was happening. The house was still shaking. Okay, cabinet shook for a couple of seconds. That's in Midland, 182 kilometers east. So that would be about 113 miles, again, east. Another one from Midland says, I'm sitting at a large, heavy electric recliner, or I'm sitting in. It started noticeably shaking, causing the computer on my lap to shake. The shaking lasted 10 to 15 seconds. Multiple people in their office said they felt it. That was also in Midland. A lot of reports coming from them. 10th floor of the building was shaking. 156 miles east in Big Springs, it says here. Blinds on the house started swinging and desk was rattling. Nothing fell off the walls, but it was most certainly felt. Let's see. Aftershock moved the whole building. Window blinds moving crazy. Let's see. Felt in my apartment shake like a shockwave coming through it. Intensity level 6 means it was felt by all. Many were frightened. Some may have run outdoors. Falling plaster chimney damage is small, it says. So I wanted to see who was reporting intensity level 6. I'll have to go to Google Earth. We got that one close to the location, and then another one. Let's go to Google Earth. So this is probably an extension of the Rio Grande fault zone, which is marked out in red here, and this here is the location of the 5.4. Someone over here said they had some damage. I wonder who they were. I wonder if they got some offices over here or something. What else do we got? Yeah, I don't see any homes. Just mostly, I'm sure there probably is something. What's this over here? Yeah, just all oil and gas production there. All right, let's bring it out a little bit more. This is the 5.4. Now, on the 6 month, June 15th of this year, there was a magnitude 4.4. near this location. Let me look around some more and see if I can see anything. You can just see all the little dots for all the platforms and different areas for wastewater disposal. All right, over here is Meltone. There's Meltone. All right, I found that. Yeah, it's just a small little town. The only monitor that I got to work was Guadalupe in New Mexico. Yeah, I have never gotten any of the monitors for Texas to work, such as that one. See, it says TX. TX. Was that the one I got to work? Let's see. No, it was not. Was it this one that I got to work? Yes, right there. Across the border. Yep. EMSC also said on Twitter that it was not a fracking earthquake. It was more likely from salt water disposal wells or fault associated with the Rio Grande Rift. Right there. Now, if you go to the moment tensor balls, here you can see we have uplift and spreading. Yeah, they put a little bit too much water into the ground, I would say. One of the aftershocks of 3.8, 13 people said they felt it. Moment tensor ball shows the same thing. Yeah, they put a little bit too much water in the ground, or that salt water, you know, with all those toxic chemicals. All right, I'm back. It's been about an hour. My daughter showed up, and then my son called me, and yeah, things happen. But anyways, I downloaded from that one site, and you can see all the aftershocks. We got the one quake there marked in red. There's actually another one right there. And another one right there. And we got another one. Oh, went small. See? Okay, another one there. Let me just pull this over so you guys can see it. This is one. Oops, doesn't. Yeah, that was the most recent datum. It's not going to show it. But anyways, let's check this out. Now remember, this is the Rio Grande Rift. This is an area that was originally going to pull apart. Yeah, divide up the country just like up there. Oh, the New Madrid Fault Zone. Yeah, so I'm not surprised we see this. And yeah, we got heated water here. Yeah, it actually came in as a magnitude 5.42. But look at all these earthquakes that they added in. That was one long earthquake. They added that one in there. I'll have to make that bigger. That really surprises me. They added that one. And they added that one. Let me pull it over. It really rattled for a long time. That one there. They added that one. All right, I'm looking for some other data. Now here on the shake map for U.S., it says magnitude or intensity, I should say, 7. Wow. Yeah, I'm sure they got some of the pipeline shut down and they're inspecting them, because intensity level 7 means everybody runs outdoors, damage to buildings varies on the quality of the construction noticed by drivers of automobiles. All right, I did find this intensity versus distance. It was felt. You can see here we got 1,000 kilometers. So that would be about 600 miles. Let me pull this over so I can see that better. Yeah, well, it says here, yeah, kilometers, 973.9 kilometers. But it doesn't give me the location, I don't think. Yeah. Well, what happens if I, nope, nothing works if I click on it. Yeah, that's pretty intense. Yep. Like I said, the oil and gas company, they don't care. They're the bad guy. You can call them anything you want. Long as they can swim in, who was it? McDuck and his vault where he swam in his money. Yeah, yeah. And then over here we got intensity level. Yeah, Let's see what we got there. Yeah, 6.3 intensity. So the red line is the Rio Grande Rift, and rivers often follow, fault zones, and you can see it going right through here, and this is the location of all those earthquakes. So did you feel it? If so, please put that information down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be safe. Always be prepared for any type of disaster. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.